Now, Qatar's foreign minister has vowed to support all efforts to maintain stability in Libya. Mohammed bin Abdul Rahman Al Thani met his Libyan counterpart, Najla Al Mankouch, in the capital, Tripoli. He's also holding talks with Prime Minister Abdul Hamid Dbeibeh. Well, Qatar backed Libya's UN-recognized unity government against warlord Khalifa Haftar. Let's now speak to our correspondent, Malik Trainer. He's in Tripoli for us. Malik, can you talk us through the situation, the security situation now in the country, and what, if anything, might come out of this meeting?
Well, in terms of securities, after this political agreement, things seem to be pretty peaceful. There's a nationwide ceasefire that's been going on since December last year, so there isn't any current fighting going on. This new interim, the Government of National Unity, came into power last March, and that was through efforts by the international community, especially Qatar. Qatar played a crucial role in bringing about the agreement, the peaceful agreement that brought in this government. So today, the Qatari Foreign Minister, Mohammed Thani, visited Tripoli. He met, as you said, with the Prime Minister, Abdul Hamid Dbeibeh, the Foreign Minister. He also met with the Presidential Council, the head and the deputies. And he is currently now meeting with Khalid al-Misri. He's the Speaker of the High Council of State. I think this is seen, you have to remember, in Western Libya, Qatar is seen as a very strategic ally, as someone who helped them in their aspiration to become a democratic state. Qatar was one of the first countries that stood with Libyans and supported Libyans when they rose up against Muammar Gaddafi in 2011 in a revolution. So they were seen as someone who, as a country that supported their efforts and supported their fight for a free and democratic Libya. Today, they discussed a few things. They discussed Mohammed Thani in the press conference, and the Libyan foreign minister said that they were coming up with committees to discuss former agreements. These are agreements that were signed by the internationally recognized Government of National Accord, the predecessors. There were security agreements, combating terrorism agreements. So they were discussing bringing about committees and re-implementing those previous agreements. Najla Mangouche, the foreign minister, also requested that the diplomatic mission of Qatar return to Tripoli and begin its work from here. They also discussed that they don't want to see foreign intervention in Libya. They want to bring about a stable Libya. You have to remember there are over 20,000 foreign fighters or mercenaries currently in the country, and that's going to be a huge impediment to having elections in December this year. But I think many here see this visit by the Qatari foreign minister as one that will help bring about stability and help this government bring about elections later on this year.
Malik Trainer there with all the latest for us from Tripoli in Libya. Thanks so much, Malik.